other than what's on committee of the whole, because it's on committee of the whole, then you can address us then, and we'll, you'll be recognized. Okay. All right, official reports. Proclamation recognizing the second place finish of the Vernon Hills High School varsity volleyball team. Is there anybody here for that? Okay. Yeah, let me get the sheet out here.
Bring them up.
Yeah, come on up.
Come on up, guys.
That's all, is this everybody?
All but four.
All but four.
I don't know, some of these guys look pretty tall. Okay.
There's a small man back in the back there. Where is she? I can see her. Oh, hi. I can see a little head back there.
If any of the parents want to come up here and take a picture.
Yeah, feel free.
You want to take a picture?
You come up behind us, you get better pictures.
Probably haven't taken about 4 million, right? All right, it's all up to you. You can go all the way around if you want.
Yeah, come on through there, and just don't trip over anything, hurt yourself. Why don't you let those little short ladies back there in front of you guys, so they can show up in the picture.
Now, what are these, what do you girls do?
We're the managers.
Well, step up then. Is that, who's the blonde lady in the back there? What's?
She's hiding.
Well, yeah, okay. Is that about right? Is that better for a photo op?
That should be better.
You can take any place you want, so.
Who are you missing?
I'm dancing, yeah.
There you go.
Guys, come on up, dance.
There's been a couple pictures taken.
One, two, go Cougars.
Okay, I'm gonna turn the reading of the proclamation over to Trustee Cook. You got the honors. No, but I mean,
Yeah.
Cook coached, didn't you?
Did you?
Not for a few years. The last time I went to state. Yes, some of them in middle school. Yeah.
Do you admit to that, any of you?
They're nodding their heads.
Did you learn anything off of her? Okay, go ahead, Tom.
Almost certainly won a junior high conference championship. They do that all the time.
Yeah.
There you go.
So that's good, right?
Absolutely, that helps.
Yeah, well, all the guys that are juniors and seniors both won, right? Yeah. Okay, that's why in the sectionals it was so easy to beat like Zurich and Barrington, because we're used to that, right? A proclamation recognizing the second place state finish of the Vernon Hills High School 2015 varsity volleyball team. Whereas the 2015 varsity volleyball team finished the season with a record of 31-10, we'll come back to the other part of that. On the road to the state, the Cougars defeated Mundelein Carmel, Arlington Heights Hersey in regionals, and Lake Zurich and Barrington in sectional play. And at the IHSA state finals, the Cougars topped O'Fallon and Carl Sandburg, but lost to Glenbard West in the title game. And the team members are Adrian Berlinski, Jake Atkinson, Dylan DeBoer, Johnny McDonald, Corey Levin, Matt Kushner, Alan Polishek, Isaiah Liu, Quinn Fraboni, Jared Bennett, Lem Turner, Adam Weinberg, Zach Umansky, Ian Thorne, Enrique Lamone, and Chris Winter. Head coach Chris Curry, assistant coach Charles Mann, assistant coach Paul Zickert, assistant coach Allison Fink, assistant coach Abby Gutzmer, and assistant coach Chris Kubacki. Therefore, Roger Byrne, the president, and the board of trustees of the Village of Vernon Hills hereby proclaim that the Vernon Hills High School 2015 varsity boys volleyball teams to be congratulated for their second place finish in the IHSA state finals. Congratulations. Yes.
Are there any captains on the team?
I'm is the captain of service.
Hello.
Okay, you got come to the presentation altar.
There you go.
Oh, that's on. Okay, cool.
They'll hear you.
It's on or off?
It's on.
It's on.
Yeah.
I'm a loud person, though, so.
Go ahead.
It's cool. Well, we weren't even supposed to make it past our regional championship. We got seeded 7, and we had a 2 seed in our regional championship. And so right from the get-go, we were the underdogs. Like Coach Carey said in the season, no one believed in us except us. And obviously you see how far that got us. And so that just shows how much teamwork and like a bond that we had as not just like a team, but as like a brotherhood can really take you.
All right.
It's true.
Anything else?
Thank you for proclaiming our team.
All right.
Nice job.
Hold on a second. Coach, you want to go up and say a few words?
No. Trying to get Coach Mann to say a few words for 10 years now. You at Vernon Hills should be very proud of these guys. They, in addition to finishing 2nd in the state, which is very difficult to do, are an IHSA Team Academic Award winner, and they represent the community well. None of these guys are in trouble in school or out of school. They're an excellent group of young men, which is a large reason they had the success they had. And we're very happy to represent Vernon Hills. And thank you 17 years ago for building a Vernon Hills High School.
You're welcome. We could do this. Hey, now, I just want to know, who's Umansky? Okay. And Winter. Okay. All right. Him I recognize. You I should. But they live in the in my hood. They live in my hood. You know? So, I mean, you know, these kids change, they get older, blah, 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 you know. Okay. Well,
and a couple of these guys, Lem is going on to play ball at Ball State, yeah. And who else is Dylan?
Stevens Institute, which is the D3 National Championship.
Yeah, yeah. So all right. Some of these guys are going on.
Hey, get one of the women up here. Say something. What do you?
Joy.
Okay, come on. You got to have a humorous anecdote to tell about these guys, right? Are you a senior?
Yeah.
Did you already graduate?
Yeah, I have.
Well, say whatever you want.
Yeah.
It's on the record.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's off the record. Yeah.
We're lucky kind of dating, but.
Well, I really liked the season with these guys. They made a lot of fun of me, so that was great.
Oh.
Especially when I cried a lot. So thanks, guys.
Oh, that's special. You made her crack.
She got a little nervous.
Okay.
You can pay him back now.
I mean, you weren't crying because they were mean to you.
Oh, no, they weren't mean. Okay. It was all in good, nice. Good part.
That's very nice.
Yeah, you were the nicest.
Now, where are you going to school next year?
Oh, I'm going to Michigan State.
Oh, that's not a good thing.
Oh, no. It is.
No, only kidding. Hey, congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations to all of you.
And let me just add a couple. The program has, in the last 6 years, since we're looking at the Hawks, come within an eyelash of being in the state finals 4 times in the last 6 years, mm-hmm. been to the sectional title game twice that were extremely close matches that could have gone downstate. And in fact, the team that won state when this team was downstate 4 years ago was the team they beat in the semifinals, one of the state powers. Sandberg is always there and always tough. And yes. And it was an amazing match when they beat them. And that Glenbard West team, I can tell you from having watched a lot of volleyball, that team had 40 wins this year. And volleyball is, you win 2 sets out of 3. 38 of their 40 wins were in 2 sets. That's an amazing team. You know, I mean, and they were just one of those kind of teams that only one set, the whole state tournament, only one team, Naperville North, another big power, scored 19 points in 1 set. That was it. Nobody else scored more than 16 out of 25 against those guys in the whole tournament. So this is a really great second place finish.
Okay, guys. Good guys. Congratulations.
Good job. Good for you. Coach,
what?
Do you have papers for
Oh, yeah. All right, Coach.
Can I say something?
And there's a copy for everybody.
Oh, you are all invited to the after party at Allen's house.
All right.
What's the, you going to give us the address or what, you know?
No.
They're just trapping us like a bad habit.
They're just running right out.
Thanks again.
Thank you. Good luck, everybody.
Okay.
I just love doing stuff like this.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's nice. I mean, you know, it's...
My daughter. I know. Oh, my
it's, you know, our high school.
Second in state.
I didn't know that.
It's 17.
You should tell
us about
that.
Yeah, 99.
Holy crap.
Well, the first year was just freshman, remember?
His daughter was high jump, second in the state.
Kristen's coaching, and her jumper, that second.
Oh, it's Vernon Hills.
Yeah, Noah.
Noah, yeah. Couldn't get him to come out for volleyball because he wanted to stay with track.
Yeah, well, that's because of my daughter.
No, his daughter.
Damn. Okay, what else?
Talk to you.
Our other high school.
Other high school, Adeline.
We got Stevenson someplace down here.
Okay, right here.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Okay. Like to read a proclamation into the record congratulating Adelaide E. Stevenson High School on its 50th anniversary. For five decades, Adelaide Stevenson High School has built a reputation as one of the top high schools in the nation. Stevenson High School serves students from Lincolnshire, Buffalo Grove, Long Grove, and Vernon Hills. Before the school was founded, area students attended Ela Vernon High School in Lake Zurich. In 1964, Ela Vernon High School District 125 residents voted to build a second school for students living in the eastern half of the district. Political strife between the two halves led to a second vote in June 1965 that saw homes in the Lake Zurich area cede and create a new district. That vote and subsequent move left the then unnamed high school with an unfinished building and no school board, administration, or faculty with just a few months until school was supposed to begin. A school board was quickly formed, teachers were hired, and the building was completed. The school board decided to name the new school in honor of former governor and ambassador Adelaide E. Stevenson II. The first school year saw a school population of 467 students and 31 teachers. The school's first expansion came in 1970 with the addition of more classrooms, a swimming pool, and other facilities. A total of seven additional construction projects between 1975 and 2001 brought the school to its current size of 720,000 square feet on 77 acres. Enrollment peaked in the 2005-06 school year when nearly 4,600 students were on campus. Stevenson High School is the only public school in Illinois to receive four Blue Ribbon Awards for Excellence in Education from the U.S. Department of Education, having it in 1987, 91, 98, and 2002. Stevenson High School is regularly ranked one of the nation's top high schools by Newsweek, U.S. News, and World Report. Now, therefore, be proclaimed that I, Roger L. Byrne, President and Board of Trustees, do hereby express its sincerest congratulations and well wishes to Adelaide E. Stevenson High School on its 50th anniversary. Encourage the residents of the village of Vernon Hills to celebrate the achievements of Stevenson High School and its students. Okay, is there anybody here from Stevenson High School?
No.
Okay, do we tell them to come?
I think we try.
Okay. Well, congratulations on 50 years.
Yes.
There ought to be a concert, though, right? We had Creedence Clearwater and what was it?
It was a BE that I didn't
know. That was
my own conference.
I don't know.
Somebody else. Gin Blossoms. Okay. Village Manager 2015 Relay for Life of GLMV.
Yeah, thank you, Your Honor. This is just a reminder for everybody that the Chamber is going to be coordinating and participating in the 2015 Relay for Life on June 27th at Century Park. So it's just an encouragement for people who might be interested either to sponsor a walker or go out for the event itself to do that.
Okay. They don't spend the night anymore?
No, they do not. They've changed that a couple years ago. Yeah.
I wonder if it was the tornado that got their attention.
That may have convinced them.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I remember being at that one. Okay. Assistant Village Manager, 2015 Arbor Theater Concert Series.
Thank you, Your Honor. With school out and finally the summer weather is finally here, the start of the summer concert series, and that's with the Arbor Theater Concerts. The Arbor Theater Concerts are held each Thursday from 7 to 9 p.m., starting next week Thursday on June 25th with Spoken For. On Thursday, July 9th, with the Midwest Dueling Pianos. July 23rd, Generation 60s Experiment. July 30th, Wild Daisy. And lastly, August 6th, Chicago Tribute Anthology. We've posted information on the Village's website and social media outlets, and we'll make sure the information is also published in the Village's email blast.
He's working on it. He can get it fixed.
No way.
I don't care about that. Is there a place to plug in my phone into the computers, or are they that old?
They are that old.
These are just monitors we've had for what?
Long time.
Is it in the back?
No.
Okay, fine. All right.
We need an adapter.
Oh, I don't care about that. I wanted to charge my phone.
I have it in the outlet. Do you have a charger?
It won't work.
Where?
Adapter.
I got a USB. Oh, you're gonna plug
anybody
it into
have
there?
A USB? Okay.
Yeah, well, that'll help. Yeah.
I do, but mine's in the car. If I go to the car, I'm not coming back.
Yeah, if you want, I'll go to the car.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. It's like a miracle. Yeah. Okay.
Also, to my report, the Lake County, Illinois Genealogical Society recently contacted the Village regarding a request to renew their lease for the lower level of the Village Hall. The Village first approved that lease back in 2011 and then approved an additional two-year extension in 2013. This results in their lease expiring this coming August 20th of this year. Staff is seeking direction from the board to prepare a resolution to authorize a three-year extension of the lease using the same terms of the agreement, as well as the same $100 per month lease rate that we currently have.
So you're asking for a recommendation or a motion?
A motion, excuse me.
All right. I'll make a motion to extend the lease for 3 years and prepare in $100 a month.
What's the exact space they're in still? The old library space?
Yes.
Correct.
Okay. And do they, so they have all their own equipment and such in there? And
yes, they're actually currently utilizing the old library bookshelves.
And so what kind of, you know, daytime traffic do they get of the public coming in and out of there?
Traffic volume is relatively low. They've had, I believe, approximately six individuals in the last week, based off their logbook of people who have signed in.
But can you go in there and ask them to do an ancestry.com type thing?
Yeah, they're very knowledgeable. It's not
theirs is strictly just on Lake County matters.
It's not just on Lake County. They have information from all over the country, and they're very knowledgeable about the resources available, both that they have as well as the other individuals.
Well, did they advertise that at all?
I'm not sure exactly. I can find out what resources they have to publish that information.
Does anybody on staff want to speak to this one?
Well, they're a small group of volunteers that kind of do their best in this. I don't know if they have a website or not, but it's a very low budget show run by a bunch of very enthusiastic folks.
But did they disseminate information to, like, the press? And
I imagine only on request.
They do have a website.
Well, okay, so who benefits from, you know, their knowledge? And can we just incorporate it on our website that we have this tenant in here?
Absolutely.
Or is this just something that?
No, it's good.
Well, I mean,
we should. No.
Yeah.
I mean, this is a use where if you want to go find out what your past is, you'll come and find it. Yeah. I mean, we can absolutely add it to our website and do whatever we can do to help kick up the traffic here. So be,
but I mean, did,
we can do that.
I'm just asking. I mean, has anybody utilized these folks, you know?
Six people in the last week.
Yeah.
Okay. Believe, and that's just according to the guest book. I'm sure other individuals got by.
Working for nothing.
And I believe,
well, I understand. Just
and I believe that the library does on occasion highlight them in their newsletter to say that,
right,
so that if the, and they do programs through the library too. So I think that they're small, but yes, I'm sure they've got a connection with the library, and if people, if we put it on our website, then people can utilize it if they want to.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
And they do have their own website, so we'll make sure that that link is incorporated into.
You know, and I think what we'll also do is ask Mike Storto and Lynn Brandel to do a program for them too, so that we can give them the maximum exposure on Channel 4.
I appreciate that.
So.
That'd be cool.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay.
There's a motion.
We got a motion in a second.
Okay. Oh, on the lease.
On this.
Motion in a second. Any other comments or questions? If none, roll call.
Trustee Hibda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Motion carries. Are they funded in any way? Or is this just?
I don't think they are.
Does anybody, you know?
Who comes up with $100?
Well, they do. I don't know. Maybe the library.
Through their member contributions.
Yeah. So there are.
There are people that contribute.
Mean around the county.
Correct.
Okay.
I'm not aware of any outside funding that they get at all.
Okay.
All right. What somebody's worried about it making, paying the $1,200 a year.
No, I'm not worried about that. Okay. All right, omnibus vote agenda. Is there a motion to approve items A through S?
So made.
Right. Second.
Motion is second. Any comments, questions, or things you have to be pulled or voted on separately? No. If not, roll call.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Trustee Hibda?
Aye.
Motion carries. Okay, unfinished additional business. Approval of Kemper voucher list of bills dated June 16th, 2015 in the amount of $13,053.79.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion and second. Comments or questions? If none, roll call.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Abstain.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Trustee Hibda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Motion carries. B, approval of village board minutes of June 2nd, 2015. Is there a motion to approve?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Comments, questions, deletions, corrections? If none, roll call.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Trustee Hibda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Motion carries. Okay. C, approval and passage of resolution 2015-106, a resolution granting approval to operate an outdoor merchandise display and sales establishment for Steinhoffels located at 569 North Milwaukee Avenue.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion and second. Comments or questions? If none, roll call.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Trustee Hibda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
I will vote no in that I want to be consistent. I did so earlier during the Committee of the Whole meeting, and I have no problem with them doing an outdoor, but I wanted to see them push it back away from the traffic pathway there. So I am a no.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Motion carries. Okay, new business. Approval and passage of resolution 2015-117. Resolution granting approval to operate an outdoor sales event for Dick's Sporting Goods located at 700 North Milwaukee Avenue. Is there a motion to approve? Oh, you want to
conversation.
Yeah, like to see.
You want to change our minds?
Good afternoon. Thanks for having us.
No.
Yes, I would like to change your mind.
No, okay. What, I asked for a motion to approve.
Oh, then no, I would not like to change it.
Well, you might have to. If nobody makes it and nobody seconds it.
Just want to hear it.
Is there a motion to approve?
He's speaking for us.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion to second. Now what? You against it?
No, I am for.
You work for Dick?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If there's no comments or questions, roll call.
Trustee Williams?
Why me first? Aye.
Trustee Hebda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Do I have
to? No, you don't have time to say anything.
You're okay.
You're good to go.
He's off the street, but it looks a whole lot. I'm sorry, what was the duration here again?
It's only for 4 days.
All right. Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Motion carries.
You got to go.
What do you want to say?
Thank you.
Just say thank you.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Yeah.
We'll do better this year than we did last year.
Thank you.
It's approved.
Thank you.
Okay. Go call Dick. Okay. What else? Anything? We have to go into closed session to discuss what? Everything? Personnel, litigation, land acquisition?
No land acquisition, but the other two, yes.
Personnel and litigation?
Correct.
Okay. But we'll do that after committee of the whole.
Yep.
Okay. So is there a motion to adjourn the board meeting?
So made.
Second.
Who are you? You're here for what? No, you're okay.
We're still going.
You're good. You're good.
No, just relax, okay?
You're good to go.
You mean the Honorable James E. Schultz?
Do you know him? Is he a neighbor?
He's holding his tongue. He's not speaking.
Okay. All right. Okay. So, is there a motion to adjourn the board meeting? Okay, roll call.
Trustee Hebda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Motion carries.
I said it twice.
I'd like to call the committee of the whole meeting to order. First item is approval of committee of the whole meeting minutes of June 2nd, 2015. Is there a motion to approve?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion and a second. Comments, questions, or any deletions or corrections? If not, roll call.
Trustee Hebda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Motion carries. Is there another? Schultz, Schwartz, or is that the new person?
Jeannie. Trustee Jeannie.
Okay. All right. First item, request of CDW to operate an outdoor special event at 200 North Milwaukee Avenue.
Thank you.
Can I state your name for the record? I know who you are.
Tim Keating.
Is that it?
That's all you asked?
Junior.
And you're employed by who?
I'm employed by CDW.
What's your capacity?
I'm a solutions architect at CDW.
How did you get this assignment?
I was requested to be here by Michelle Marks, who's the organizer of the race.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Okay, I'll ask Mike Atkinson to speak to this one.
Yeah, Michelle Marks is the one who coordinated the event last year as well, and it seemed to be successful. It's pretty much the same as last year. It's a 5K run that's for family members, friends. It's not open to the public. Proceeds benefit the Lurie's Children's Hospital. They'll have about 125 participants. It would be staged from CDW. It goes through Vernon Hills High School property. They have permission from them. Routes around back to CDW without crossing a major arterial. The event would take place excuse me, on Sunday, July 26th, from 8 a.m. to 9:30 p.m. So tonight, if the committee feels that the special event is appropriate, staff should be directed to prepare a resolution approving the outdoor event subject to the conditions outlined in your packet.
Do you want to say anything to convince us not to approve this?
No, sir.
That's the right answer. Okay, is there a motion to approve? So anybody have a question?
Yes.
Oh, Trustee Schultz does.
I'm going to vote in favor of this, and I'm wholly in favor. However, you threw me off my game because there was two things I wanted to bring up during communication. We kind of blew by, but one of them is very apropos to this. I already talked to Manager Kalmar about this, but the Girls on the Run seemed to be an extremely successful event in that it had a high level of participation. And I've even found out more about this organization because where I hold my second dual citizenship, they are holding a Girls on the Run event. I believe it's in Manitowish Waters, which is the next town over. And it seems to be quite a ongoing enterprise. And they do a lot of good things in the world of mentoring young women. With that being said, the immediate after-action report that we received indicated that we were stressed, we were strained in accommodating it for a number of reasons. Most of them were just simple logistics and project management, for lack of a better term. So I don't expect this event to put that level of stress on us, so I think you'll do just fine, and I have no problem with it. But when we start getting these larger events, I think we need to think about them a little bit more. And so I've asked Manager Kalmar there to kind of do a better detailed or an additional detailed after action analysis. So we can come up with a checklist to say, hey, maybe we need certain things, maybe we need more participation from the organizers in the way of physical labor to do some setup, to move things around, to help control flow and things, whatever it is. I'm not trying to solve that right now, but I'd like to come up with a better plan so that if Girls on the Run comes back next year and says we're going to have 6,000 runners, we'll be able to accommodate 6,000 runners. It may require some significant logistics on their part, and they're going to need to be able to pony up to help support that. But with that being said, I'd like for us to pursue that. Getting back to CDW.
I was just going to say this isn't Girls on the Run.
I know. And getting back to this, I'm all in favor, and I'm willing to go forward with the vote.
Can I ask a question? Oh, you want to ask a question? Go ahead.
No, I just have a comment. I just wanted to say Laurie Children's Hospital is an amazing place. I hope none of you ever have to use it, but if you do, you are, I can't begin to tell you how wonderful that hospital is.
Yeah.
It is so wonderful. So anything I can do to support them, I certainly would do it. And therefore, I do support your organization and what it's doing over there. And if I didn't make the motion, I do.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, we have a motion then?
You do that.
And a second.
And a second.
Yes.
Yep.
Okay, roll call.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Trustee Hibda?
Aye.
For the record, I'd vote aye. So motion carries.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I'll do my best.
Good luck.
I mean, are you guys involved, help with this event? No.
No, there's nothing.
Because they're running around the high school.
That's right. They're really contained.
I'm sorry. They're totally contained in the park there.
Yeah.
It's wonderful.
Okay.
It's not a lot of people.
Manageable numbers.
Is there a baseball tournament or anything?
Probably.
Not that will be impacted with this, no. There is not a tournament at the same time as this, no.
This is early in the morning for me, 39:30. Not that the baseball is, okay. But
it's 3 miles. 3.1.
If you want to leave, you can.
Thank you.
There's no strings attached.
Good luck.
Okay. Okay. Holiday.
Oh, yeah.
Consideration of a new monument sign for the Commons at Town Center. Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Taxman Corporation is making this request for the new sign that would replace the existing wood sign adjacent to Route 45. It advertises the apartments in the mixed-use building in the Town Center. The proposed setback of 18 feet complies with the 15-foot setback requirement of the sign code. The proposed height of 4 feet and size of 24 square feet are well within the limits of the sign code, 8 feet max, 50 square feet max. There would be landscaping at the base of the sign, and that's subject to review and approval by the village's landscape technician. And for tonight's meeting, the village, the county needs to determine if this proposed sign would change the concept of the original approved PUD for the Town Center. That would be Ordinance 2007-31. If the COW feels the sign is substantial and changes the concept or intent of the PUD, then the matter should be referred back to the Planning and Zoning Commission for further consideration and reopening of the public hearing to amend the PUD. If the COW feels the changes are minor and support the overall intent of the PUD, then it would be appropriate to recommend an amendment of the approved ordinance. Staff, in reviewing the sign, feels the changes do support the intent and concept of the PUD. The smooth precast stone is similar to the materials approved for the Vernon Hills Town Center signs that are out there right now, and the design is also consistent with what has been approved in the past. Attached to your packet is a copy of the site plan, landscape plan, and elevation drawings. And for tonight, if the COW feels that the changes are appropriate, then staff should be directed to prepare an ordinance amending Ordinance 2007-31 as amended to allow the development identification sign in accordance with the conditions that are outlined in your packet. And a representative of Taxman is here to answer any questions that you might have.
I was just gonna say.
Is there lighting?
I can't find. You okay?
Yeah.
All right.
I'll find it.
You wanna look at this one?
Yeah, thank you.
I was just gonna say, sign may be good as a harbinger of things to come.
Absolutely.
That's all I have to say. Trustee Schultz.
The only thing I have to say is it's about time. Thank you.
Yeah.
Motion to direct staff to proceed with the necessary paperwork to move forward with this. I, too, do not see this as a major change that requiring additional zoning review. So you have your motion.
There's a motion in a second. Trustee Hebda.
The phone number on the sign, if that should change, how are you going to take care of that? Is that engraved in the
panel?
It's a panel. Okay. So it's down and put in the stone. Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. That's like, is that called Ludwig?
That's
who
it is.
That's their
it's up in the office. We have an office in the building.
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
But Karen from Ludwig would answer the phone. Yeah.
Right. Karen Williams. That's just a panel that's put onto the stone.
Right.
Right.
One more question, though.
You need to talk into the microphone.
Are you the sign lady?
Our sign consultant.
I am. Yes. Cindy Fitzpatrick with Heritage Signs in Libertyville.
Yeah.
The phone number panel would be mounted with removable decorative standoffs in each corner, and they merely they bolt into the structure, and then we sandwich the acrylic in between, and then finish it off with the decorative bolt.
Good. Okay. Thank
you. Yeah. Okay. So it's changeable.
I mean, I just wondering if it's changeable or if it's in
question.
Good.
There you go. Mm-hmm.
Trustee William, you want anything else? Trustee?
No, that was my main question.
I noticed that it says that the stone portrayed in the drawing does not reflect the color of the stone. What color is the stone?
I have an example of the stone. If you'd like to see
yes,
it.
Yes, I would.
Sure.
Is it in the car?
No, it's right there. And why she's looking, how is it lit?
It's an Indiana limestone, and referred to it as a color gray. This will match all the other structures out there.
Yes, it does.
Okay.
How is the sign lit, or is it lit?
We'll have lights coming up from the ground, just like the other
just side. Reflecting
like the other side.
Yeah, shining up on
it. Okay, that's it. No problem.
Okay, there's a motion and a second. If there's no further comments or questions, roll call, please.
Trustee Markwart?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Trustee Hibda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
And tell Mr. Taxman he should have came and said hi. Tell him Barbara Cy said should've he should have come and said hi.
Yeah, okay.
He's usually always here.
Probably out fishing.
My thing's gonna die. Do I need it anymore?
Nah.
Go good.
All right, thank you.
What are we here? I think that's it.
Right.
Isn't it?
Okay. Next is,
I'll just use yours.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Is it?
No, my battery just died.
Senior bus.
That's right.
That's okay. I know about that.
Were you doing the holiday show or?
Holiday decoration?
Yes. That one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. I know that one, too.
Hello?
I'm here.
We have flashing Christmas lights on our monitors.
Well, I know at the last.
They're flashing.
Everybody at home?
Stuart will work on that for us. Thank you.
This is an ad for Poltergeist.
Yes.
Let's see. So I guess at the last board meeting, there was discussions as far as the light show and the future of the light show. What we've, the light show has been fantastic for 21 years. We've had over 1 million people go through the the light show. Yes.
Wow. That's impressive.
Yeah, I did some quick math. 400,000 vehicles traveled through the light show. If you figure average of 2.5 people, that's 1 million. So a lot of people have enjoyed it. It's really hard to compete with our past, and so I know Village Manager Kalmar had shared before.
You count RVs and stuff?
No.
You know, you throw that in the math, it's still over the 1 million.
That's just a good.
Yeah. So I guess in terms of the future of the light show, it was discussed at the last meeting. What we're really trying to do is share what the vision may be. We really shouldn't try to compete with the beautiful Cuneo grounds and everything that it afforded to us. And so really trying to work with the board in terms of what we may do moving forward. In terms of some ideas and concepts that staff has went through, you know, one idea is just really have it just clean and crisp. We can add something similar to these wreaths around the village at all of our entry signs. We can work with the business community. I was going to ask Taxman if they would allow wreaths to be added at the old half-day area. We could work with Continental Executive Park, Corporate Woods, talk to them. Would they agree to add some wreaths? And so we have this common theme that we would have throughout the village. I know there's some interest in terms of the golfer animatronic, and we are going to save that. We're going to bring it over to the golf course and work with you as far as where it should go.
Play 24/7.
Yes.
Starting as soon as it's put up.
Yes, yes.
It'll certainly draw people into the golf course. What is this thing?
It will add some extra. It will add some extra excitement to the Muni, certainly. So you know, that was one thing we were looking at, is keeping the golfer. The northeast corner presents some good opportunities. We'd still like to have something at the northeast corner of 21 and 60. I've talked with my staff. They've talked about maybe the snowflake or some of the deer. And so we'd like to keep displays similar to that for the northeast corner. And if you have some thoughts as far as what may go at the northeast corner,
you think,
entertain that.
Would the folks at Hawthorne would like it? Westfield? Anything?
I'm sorry, could you ask that again? Would Hawthorne Mall?
Would Westfield like anything?
Would they like anything? We can reach out to them and ask them whether or not they would like some of the displays also. One thing that we found in terms of the displays, they look very attractive at night. They don't look so good during the day. What you're really looking at is just the rusted rebar cage. There's a guy wire that holds them up. If someone's climbing on these, they're not as stable as they should be given the extra weight. But we certainly could reach out to
you know what?
Them all
you
on that.
Could put them on the roof. That's true. You could put a lot of that stuff on somebody's roof, right?
Are there some displays that are nice enough that we'd have like one or two by the Village Hall, a couple by the library, just, you know, the, or some of the other municipal buildings in town that just adds to the police station? Just to add to the festiveness as people drive through? Yeah, the fire department.
What staff's recommendation is not to have the existing ones that we use for the light show. We'd like to go in a different direction, that we use more crisp lighting, LED lights, and decorate our buildings very well, but not with the displays that we have right now.
Question I have, I'll take it off, is that I know the displays are, the lights are on a rod, and I know they're rusty, but if we even pull those off and use some of them, putting LED lights back onto the rods that that display different looks, is that a possibility?
It is. I think whatever we end up using, we probably will recreate and build new ones rather than using the old ones. So we certainly can do that. I really think in terms of my vision and staff's vision is, I think we do a good job in terms of the municipal golf course. We'd like to replicate that. We've been trying to move towards the Village Hall in terms of just having a crisp white light. I know there's been different comments. Love to have feedback in terms of whether we should change, you know, from a white light or add some additional color to it or not. So I think it's important to still light our buildings. The police building, public works, we'll add things there. We'll add it to this building. So we will still include our buildings. But I guess the message I'm really sharing is, in terms of the lighted decorations we have, displays out at the light show, we'd really like to save a few of them, but dispose of most of them and move in that direction.
Okay, Trustee Heatherington.
Here's my vision. I like the idea of the white lights. I'd like to see some of our major entrances, like you've got on 60, that beautiful sign with those trees. And if you're not going to put anything there, I'd be disappointed. Personally, I think the wreaths, they're great during the day, but I don't think they don't do a lot for me in terms of seeing them around. I'd rather see some lit trees. I'd like to see this decorated, if we can decorate by the police department and some of the main entrances into our village, including Taxman's group down there by Philly G's, that kind of stuff. Just because otherwise it's going to be dark. Yep. You know, I like lights. And then I'd like us to reach out to Westfield to see what are they going to do with their new mall and all their grand old signs. What are they going to do?
Yeah.
And so I would hope that we could reach to them, because it's dark there and we need to bring some festive lighting to the area.
A lot of frontage. Right,
so
here.
I agree with you, Dave, though. I know those displays are bad. And, you know, but I'm personally, I like white lights. I don't want to see a bunch of colors. I like the white and the green and the red or whatever. So that's just, to me, it looks
like
nice. It's clean.
I like the colors.
So, but I don't know about the wreaths.
I like
don't
colored.
Know how expensive those are, maybe in a few places, but, okay. You know, we'll see. But that's where I'm coming from.
Good feedback.
Okay, Trustee, you want to answer that? Or?
No, other
No, he's
feedback.
Getting my feedback.
Trustee Cook.
Actually, contrary to what Trustee Hebden said, most of the comments I got last year about the golf course decorations were that there was too much white, that it was it lacked some of the holiday, and adding red and green would do something with it. But most of the comments I got were, you know, add some color here and there, okay. Especially on the trees and that, in lining the building and that kind of thing. The white was very nice, but some of the other stuff, some of the people said they would prefer more color.
Thanks for the feedback.
Trustee Schultz.
Yeah, I guess I was kind of hoping for a little more specificity with regard to what lights or what displays could be salvaged, because I'd like to see us use them, provided they're safe, okay? But any place where there's an electrical outlet, you know, that we could tie into. So, you know, the islands at CEP, the islands at Corporate Woods, the corner at Town Center, at Hawthorne, And with regard to the, you know, the cages and whatever, you know, if you take them apart and relight them with LEDs, but the cages, just hit them with a rust converter, and, you know, that turns them black, and then put another coat of black on them, and, you know, it's not going to look that bad if it's a uniform color. I guess I'd like to salvage as much as we can, because that is our heritage. We had that light show for an extensive period of time, and I guess I'd like to utilize it wherever possible in some incantation.
So because this is our first year and we're going through a transitional period, would it be acceptable for staff to go through and select 5 or 10 of the ones that we really feel we should save and declare the rest X or whatever the number
because
the board decides?
We have a lot of locations. I really believe that we have a lot of locations between the fire departments. Yeah, security is a problem. There's no doubt about it. Frosty is a good example of that.
The,
you know,
the snowman that got stolen.
Right. We
found him.
Yeah. But yeah, he was found, you know, he was found in a trunk.
Tandem to a mob hit.
Yeah, he was found in the trunk of a car, all tied up.
It was a station wagon.
I don't recall. I don't think it was a station wagon. I think it was literally in the trunk of a car.
The trunk.
But it was in Lincolnshire.
Yes.
Yeah. It was, Lincolnshire.
It was a big Cadillac to fill.
Yeah, that's it.
Yep.
Anyway, I think you get what I'm going for, is we have this heritage of the light show. And granted, we can't ever duplicate that again, but, you know, as much and the best we can. And, you know, if there's some really large stuff we can put on the island, you know, facing Lakeview in the middle of Big Bear, so you can kind of monitor from a security standpoint so that, you know, as you're driving down Lakeview or you're walking down the path, you see it. Whatever. I know. I'm becoming redundant now, but I'd like to see us utilize it as much as we can and maintain that heritage of a lit village.
So I did hear you. I do understand that. One thing that I want to make sure that the board understands as far as from a public works perspective, what work it's going to take to make sure that every one of these are lit. Right now, the system's only—it is not grounded because you drive through the light show. With the new ones, we're going to add a ground. We're going to add a GFI, and I know some of the displays that are at the golf course. A little bit of moisture will trip it, and then we need to react. We want to be successful. We want to make sure that whatever we put up, we're able to maintain and keep them lit. And so, I just wanted to share that.
Trustee Williams.
Thank you. I know that you've got to go through all of that stuff and decide what is this, what's that, what's going out, what's coming in. Could you make somewhat of an, you probably will be making somewhat of an inventory to do that. And in so doing, I would think that you're going to be thinking where to put it as you're going along. I don't know that if you've done that or not, if you've identified specific places you want to put things.
One of the other options that my staff looked at, we have cataloged and inventoried all of the displays. They have a tag on it. Ultimately, the ones that we're disposing of, it will help us do so. In terms of those specific displays, we have the inventory, and we looked at all of the different opportunities of entry points to the village and prominent locations and the possibility of adding a display at those different locations. So that is another option. It's not necessarily my recommended option, but as I heard, I don't vote, and whatever the pleasure of the board is.
So you don't feel that you could make it look to the standards that Vernon Hills would expect?
Sure.
I'm concerned of what they will look like during the daylight. Even if I spray paint them black, you're going to see that framework, and you're not going to see the lit figure. So you're going to see that during the day. I think during the night it'll look well. At some point, there's going to be moisture getting in and tripping that circuit, and then we're going to go out there and we're going to make sure that they're lit and maintained. And we've spent some time talking to Wheeling, who has their walkable event. El Funk, our mechanic, his brother-in-law is responsible for keeping that system going. And they have shared just all of the extra steps that they've taken to make sure that when you have a bulb, you have moisture on it, it heats up, it drips into the socket. They've been trying to waterproof the sockets and do everything they can so it doesn't trip that circuit. They are constantly going out and trying to dry things off, shrink wrap, et cetera, et cetera. And that's really a concern that I'm sharing.
David, question, because we brought up LED lights because of a low voltage. Wouldn't that not change? I know with the bulbs, the moisture is a big factor and unbelievable. With LED, they're normally packed where the moisture won't get into them because you buy them in strip lines. Is that a possibility?
LEDs will help us. We've also looked at ropes. So there's mm-hmm. ropes of lights that you can purchase and you can wrap them around poles. And so.
And they're encased in something.
And they're completely encased. They come in 150-foot lengths. 150-foot length for the crisper white light, they're about $600 for a 150-foot strand. So we're going to spend our budget pretty quickly with that. But there may be some prominent locations where you want to do something.
Do those like last that. More than a year?
Oh, yes.
I've never purchased, but I'm hoping that they do.
Well, there's a lot of stuff I put up on my
ones at the golf course.
It doesn't make it through the winter.
I bought the rope lights at the golf course probably, when you put up the awning. How long ago was that? And they still work. And it's the rope lights.
But those are protected.
Well, they're encased, too.
I know that, but they're not.
They're not outside.
Not outside on a tree.
The ones that we looked at had a thick casing for them. Yeah. They have certain points where you can cut them and splice them. So when a section goes bad, you can cut and replace it. Okay. So they are manageable there. There's a two-prong system. You plug in a prong this way. Oh. You have a prong this way, and it's got a sleeve. You shrink wrap it and try to keep the moisture out where you can. Yeah. But, you know, that is another option.
All right, so we won't be replacing those kind of lights every year. You know what I mean? The whole.
No.
But for 150 of these, they're how much?
They're $600 to $625 a strand of 150 feet.
Oh, 150 feet.
That's pretty long.
I thought
long.
You meant lights.
I was going to say,
that's
150
not
lineal feet.
When I first heard it, it's like when I buy at Walgreens, you know. 150 feet. Okay.
So that would serve us for, say, 7 poles that we wrap.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, gosh. You know, I mean, it sounds like when a lot of the stuff we're thinking of from the actual light show is old. So maybe we're better off going with the new technology.
We're just putting a lot of lights on trees.
I think we may be able to use some of them, but that's correct. Only some of them. But Dave had on display, which I don't know if was up on the screen, where there were like Christmas trees. And
Stuart?
If they go back on
that last screen, yeah, there you go.
That.
But if you do like a forest like that, we might make sure they flash real irritating.
Like this thing has been doing
like
all
this
night.
Thing's doing, yeah. You want them to just flash. You know, like your neighbor puts up too much light. Why don't it just flash? You know, right at your bedroom window.
And, I will comment on the. I don't know what it was that you put on the golf course building last year. The multiple lights, it looked like it was a netting. I kept going over and feeling it to make sure there was nothing on
there. You were checking out the lights.
I did. I thought, what is that? But it really looked sharp. Those were sharp.
So I think I've heard feedback in terms of the wreaths. Maybe we're not heading necessarily in the wreath direction. Let me try to summarize what I'm hearing.
Combination of.
So discussions whether we should or shouldn't have wreaths.
Well, the wreaths would be lit. No?
No.
Just, I mean something that will be recycled? I mean, like real wreaths?
We could buy fresh, new balsam ones.
Right.
We could buy the faux evergreens. Here's an example on how we've seen other communities that they wrap garland around the poles and then they add them onto a light pole. Instead of a banner, we would add a wreath. Other option looking...
Would that light pole then, would that part have been lit at night? The light is...
Just the light.
Is what's being wrapped, is that lit?
No.
It isn't, but I have seen an option where you can add a candle. So there's a plastic, not a real candle, obviously, a plastic candle, LED, and it's a candlestick inside the wreath. And that would add a light feature. And you could add that to a light pole, and we'd have the electricity.
Are any of our light bulbs have a separate plug-in and LED?
We do have receptacles on some poles that would allow for them to plug directly in, and that would be relatively easy to accomplish.
Mm-hmm.
There was a conversation as far as picture number two. You know, these are essentially 8 foot high of LED lights, and they're spanning.
Yeah, they're in a pole, and they just come down.
Yeah. So if I could get some comments as far as whether that's something that's attractive or we should consider.
They go by Roger's house on the
lake. It has to be that thick. I guess you have to have like this 30 of them. Otherwise, they look kind of spindly and scrawny. I guess to summarize my thoughts, the easiest way is that think of Vernon Hills as the Paris of Lake County. We are the Village of Lights. So
we got to have lights.
I understand your direction, Jim.
I like the wreaths, but lit, if that makes sense.
You like the wreaths, but...
You could put all those wreaths on the Vernon Hills signs that come in to town.
If they're lit, too. But again, I don't
think there's any electricity.
I don't know if there's electricity there, too. I know that's an issue, too. You've got to watch out where you're going to plug things in.
Wait a minute. Do we have a spotlight on them? Do we have spots up on our signs?
Some of them, yes. Some of them, no.
So there's lights on some of them.
Westbound
like the
60.
Like silo or
right.
Setup, there's no electricity
right.
out by that.
A good example is when you're coming from 60, crossing the Des Plaines River, and you look towards the northeast corner and our monument sign there.
Yeah.
We can add lights on it. We can add white running lights along the base of it, really accent it. If we do use a wreath, we certainly have extra electricity that we can make sure that light shines on it. So I think what I'm hearing from you, Trustee Hebda, is that you're looking for things to be illuminated.
I think, yes, absolutely, in central points. And I agree with Jim, if we're going to do those trees, colored trees, they've got to be into a grouping. And when you talk about the corner where currently the Loyola sign is, that might be an appropriate section for that, just to,
I think he's got something planned.
But you may have something planned there already. I don't know what you're thinking of, because is that billboard going to go away?
Right?
I hope it is.
The northeast corner?
Yeah. I'm not certain as far as the billboard.
Didn't that go away, or can you cover it?
We'll find the guy who stole Frosty and put him on the case of the billboard.
That sign is temporary, and we'll have more information in the upcoming about what's going on at the corner.
And I think Westfield, gosh, it's dark there. And if they want to do wreaths on the pole or something, maybe they could do something.
We have to encourage them to do something over there
they
other
need to
than
do
just
something
that
near,
one little ring of lights around that
rooftop.
South
the rooftop.
But I know that's
corner.
Not your job. I'd be happy.
No, they had one little thing around.
Michael, I'd be happy to meet with you. And what's the name of the guy from Westfield? We could talk to him about lights, too.
Tim?
Yeah, we could talk to him about some lights, too, and what they're going to do with those nice big signs.
But now that they've redone
sure.
them I would think they want to attract people.
I would hope
Christmas
exactly.
time. So they should have that lit up like a Christmas tree.
So you want it to be very inviting. Come in. You know, look, we got insides.
I agree with
outside.
Your look, a clean look. And as we all know, I mean, my husband is out there trying to plug in lights when they're gone. I'm saying, what happened to those lights on the bushes?
Oh, goodness.
I mean, it's like constant. I appreciate where you're coming
those
from
of
there.
Those of you knew my husband, the kitchen, and everyone would call it the gingerbread house. You remember.
To do that. It was nice up at Cuneo because it was all there. So, but I appreciate where you're coming from with trying to maintain that, because I'm sure that if the lights aren't lit, I'm going to say, Dave, why aren't the lights lit there? And you're going to be nice and not say anything too nasty to him. But
so you tell the guys, we're sorry. We understand you're not going to spend as much time putting up the light display, but you're going to spend a lot of time doing this too.
But
and we do appreciate
some
it.
Focal points that I think you're thinking of too, some focal points in the village that we can hopefully eliminate.
And
some,
our corporate partners.
Yes.
Corporate Woods has, what, 4 entry points? CEP has 3, kind of.
Yeah, they've got some nice.
Continental has
2.
3. Yeah.
So along there.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
4.
1, 2, 3.
3 up this way and 1 at the other end.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe it's also important, though, to realize that we may not get cooperation from our corporate
Absolutely.
Woods brethren.
No, but we can certainly encourage.
But we can encourage them if we wanted to provide them, like the Rees, for instance, as a part of this.
Sure.
That may be an option also that kind of goes hand in hand with what we're trying to do here thematically.
Mm-hmm.
It may be also worthwhile for Dave to go back with his team and create some locations for some of these things and maybe come back to you guys and say, here's where I want to do these clusters of lighted trees. Here's where I want to do these.
I'd like to see that,
kind of show you all what we're talking about here. I think you've given a lot of direction here, and I think that he can carry that back with his group and come back to you guys, you know, in the middle of the hot summer so that everybody's thinking about Christmas at that time and come back to you with some details.
For Christmas, Grandma.
We've prepared a location map with ideas at the different locations that's readily available. We can share that with, I can work with John, put that in a transmittal packet to allow the board to consume the information, then we can come back and have more of a discussion on it.
Where are you currently storing everything? Is it still on Cuneo?
Yes.
Yep.
Okay. Yes. We have 4 full trailers of displays.
I need to talk to you about the ones you're getting rid of too after the meeting.
Does anybody want to buy them?
There has been some interest on a number
some other
of them.
Towns?
Whether it's other towns, whether it's Lake County fairgrounds. There's actually some Wisconsin parks, you know, campgrounds that during the winter time they end up adding a holiday light show as part of the winter.
And actually somebody from Florida.
Yeah, we could.
From Florida?
Florida.
Wow.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's interested in the displays.
Are the trailers roadworthy?
It is not.
No, no.
That'll include all the animated plywood characters from
The characters we're going to give those away, and we've got a list of people that are interested in that and go through some sort of auction or some equitable way to share those.
Lottery, something. Yeah.
So I think I have a fairly good direction. Let me regroup. We'll prepare a map. Well, we have prepared a map with different options. We'll share that with the board, and we'll be back in touch and try to figure out what our future is.
Okay, senior bus service delivery and replacement option.
Thank you.
You're doing this one too, aren't you, Dave?
I am, sir.
Yes.
That's his too.
Can we shut off the screen now?
Yeah, I just turned mine off. Or Roger's off.
Jeez.
Thank you. So for the senior bus, there's a lot of information research that my staff, Al Funk, put together. We've looked at different options in terms of the senior bus. We've also, I know John's had a chance to meet with a few of the trustees to provide some background. So with the senior bus, right now, last year we had budgeted for a new senior bus, roughly $55,000 for a new senior bus. Because we were looking to purchase a new one, we wanted to look at our whole program and understand how we would deliver the service, what the different options are. We also looked whether we would buy a new bus, whether we would buy a used bus, whether we would lease the bus, whether we would work with Pace. And ultimately, what staff is recommending is we really need a two-step approach. We'd like to move forward. My recommendation is we work with PACE as part of their lease program. We would have a 2 to 3 year agreement with them, and it would provide a bus that we could rely on. Right now, with the level of the work that's required to the bus, we're spending a lot of money on repairing the bus. It's down, and then the seniors have to crawl into a van, which isn't real conducive ergonomically for them. So we need an interim solution. So my recommendation is that we work with PACE to have a lease arrangement for a 2 to 3 year period, and then we have more discussions. Ultimately, how do we deliver service to the seniors? We've went through as far as how much staff, what is the cost for our program, and not including the time for scheduling at the Village Hall. We're looking at about $40,000 that we pay to run this service. With that $40,000, could we spend it better and still provide a similar service or not? Those are things we'd like to investigate and provide the board with more answers. But the recommendation for tonight is we're asking the board to direct staff to move forward with PACE and have a 2 to 3 year lease arrangement, find out the details with PACE, and then come back to have you guys authorize the expenditure.
Trustee, you have to.
I just have one comment, and I'm not going to be belittling what you're saying, but I think $40,000 is the least that we can spend on these seniors. I think that the service is a real plus. I realize too that at times people take advantage of it, and we need to make sure that our parameters are appropriate for them. But I really believe that is the least we can do for these people out there who may be on a limited income that need assistance to get to either a doctor's appointment or to the grocery store or whatever. So as you look at that, that's at least where I'm coming from, Dave, that I would, I understand we've got to look at what we're doing here. And to get them in a van is very challenging too for some of these folks.
Yeah,
it's really tough. So, but I hope that, I don't want to see it go away. I'll be honest, I don't want to see it go away.
No, I think that
if we can do some comparison surveys to say, okay, what are other communities doing too, so that we have something effectively to look at. Because, rest my mother's soul, but that was a real plus for her to have that ability, because she couldn't drive to get someplace. And I think some of those people at Victory Center, and I know those who can afford Brookdale or whatever, have a great service, but there's many seniors that can't afford that. So.
Well, I guess the question, and I hear what you're saying, and what we're going to do is look at, is there a more efficient way to provide it in a cost-effective manner that is sustainable long-term for the village, but it also provides, it maintains the level of service or possibly enhances the level of service. Okay. Because, we're functioning with basically one piece of equipment and two part-time drivers. Yeah. And we provide a limousine type of service right now that is pretty high quality, but the question is there a more efficient way for us to provide the service? Maybe some ways of adding additional trips to it. If you recall, a number of years ago, the bus service was pretty widespread, so you could take the bus to Lake Forest to go to and what we found out was that was not very efficient, so you all said, wrap it up, get closer, we're going to limit the areas and those types of things. And again, I think that's something that we need to relook at over the next couple of years to determine what can we do and can we do it better. And is it something that, are there other services or other options out there? Because, we know of townships, for instance, who provide dial-a-ride service, where the seniors dial up and they have a chit or a credit that they can apply towards that ride. PACE offers a different type of service where they might be able to serve your entire community. I know Nikki has some great experiences from Highland Park in terms of how that type of service might be offered. So, that's what we're talking about here, not cutting the service, not suggesting cutting the service whatsoever. It's just how do we do it better and how do we do it in a more sustainable manner.
What was the SRA CLC bus, or what type of vehicle was that?
fairly identical to the bus we have right now. It's also about the same age. It was in relatively good condition for its age, but we think that if we were to purchase that, although it's a good price, we will have to continually put money into it, and there'd be a lot of downtime, and we wouldn't be able to provide that service to the seniors with that bus. And maybe clarifying a little bit, understand how important this is, and that's why we're having the discussions. Part of it is a capacity issue.
Yeah.
Trying to get all of our different riders to the locations they need with one vehicle, is there a better way to do it? So that's what we want to spend time talking about.
Well, okay, Trustee Schultz.
I'm ditto to what Trustee Hebda said about maintaining it. My concern, I guess, is I'd like to see us pursue the lease. I think it makes good sense. I just want to ensure that we always have a reliable bus. So that lease arrangement, you know, if the bus breaks down for an extended period of time, that the lease says, hey, you will supply us another interim bus or something, just to ensure that we have the capacity to maintain the service no matter what. So that's my only caveat on the lease. And if that costs us a couple extra bucks, so be it.
Okay, with our own bus, obviously the dispatching of it is probably what? Much swifter a response time?
Absolutely.
Okay, so we're not going to change that. I mean, I don't think anybody wants to change that. It's just the function of, yeah, if you lease it and it starts to, you know, if it's under warranty, you know, you get repairs done, right? I mean, for the first 2 years or 5 years, you know, if it's something that's not just typical maintenance. I mean, and I don't profess to know if that's accurate, what I just said. Is there some kind of a warranty here on the, you know, the powertrain and all that kind of fun stuff?
The buses, we're checking into what they have in their system currently that we would be using. We're anticipating it wouldn't be a brand new bus, but potentially it's a three-year-old bus versus right now we're dealing with an eight-year-old bus. So we think it's going to be more road-worthy. And it will serve us better with less maintenance required.
This would be a lease.
And this would be a lease.
Okay, but it's a bus coming from where? I mean, what use was it put to if it's used? What was it already put to?
Same thing. It's probably basically
I can
the same
speak
thing.
Out of turn. Just in a prior life, I did do a lot of work with Pace. Nikki Larson. We'll use 290 Evergreen for my address.
Okay.
In a prior life, I dealt a lot with Pace, and they're actually very good to work with. If you run a for-profit transit operation, they will pay for all the costs involved in it. In Highland Park specifically, they did run a complete transit system that was completely funded by Pace, but they also have a ratio of revenue that you have to meet in order to be reimbursed by Pace. There was a particular route that we ran for seniors, and they will allow you to staff it with village employees. So Dave could continue with his existing drivers.
Yeah.
And they're actually pretty good about if your bus goes down, they will provide you a replacement. So you still have control over the operation. You still pay for any expenses, payroll related to that transit service, but you have the ability to control it. It's kind of the trade-off. You pay for it, but you can control it. So you can still provide a pretty high level of service and have a backup from Pace if something happens to your bus. Whereas right now, if our bus is down, you know, we're kind of in a pickle.
We have to go to Enterprise and run a van.
Right.
Yeah. Exactly. Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, you know, okay, so we're gonna look at that.
Yes.
Okay. All right, Trustee Williams.
I just wanna say, I don't think anybody has the thought of doing away with the service.
Right.
Staff, myself, anybody sitting up here. That was not included in our discussions that we were having. Our concern was strictly the amount of miles that goes on the bus, what all is involved in operations, and the 40,000, if I'm not mistaken, did not include the time that is put into scheduling those buses. I think we, part of the things that I suggested that we look at is kind of limiting a little bit. By that, let's try to get your grocery shopping done when the sales are there, Wednesday and Thursday or something, and do it in the morning as opposed to early in the afternoon. Instead of, okay, I got to go to the doctor at 9 o'clock. Oh, by the way, come back at 1 and take me shop. You know, let's try to combine as much as we can. So it might take a little bit of meeting with the seniors once we get our thoughts together and try to sit down and come up with a plan with them. And obviously, I would be willing to sit down and do that. They can yell at me, but I can yell back because I'm one of them now. So I think Dave and John are doing a lot of work on this, and this is really the best way to go, to give us a chance to really sit down and come up with some ideas on how to continue the program.
Yeah, what's interesting, if it's PACE, they can, get you a bus, what, by the next day or something? Or
sometimes.
3 months? Yeah. They told us 3 months. Yeah. After the application, you put the application.
If it breaks down on a Monday, can you have a bus later in the week?
Sooner than that.
Yeah. Same day?
I mean, they have a whole fleet, so it's not, you know, that's kind of the benefit of
PACE. And we're all paying for it anyway.
You know, it might not be,
right?
It's a reserve bus, so you know, your temporary bus might not be, right, you know, Cadillac, but it'll still run, it'll still be functional, it'll still be fine.
Okay.
And there's other options that I'm sure we haven't thought about that we could reach out there and grab in an emergency, even when our own van goes down. I do still have a little bit of pull left at certain companies
to do something.
With. So there's things we can do.
Does anybody else want to weigh in on this? Or it's obviously going to come back. And
you're going to bring it back and figure out what, because you've got a bus that's...
Were you looking for a motion to proceed with the lease?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
To the lease.
I will make the motion to direct staff to prepare the necessary ordinance/paperwork to enter into a lease if staff so feels that is the best direction for us to move.
Second.
Motion to second. Is that with PACE?
Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It is with PACE, yes.
With the caveats that people have noted concerning availability of backup buses, et cetera, et cetera.
Okay, if there's no further comments or questions, roll call, please.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Trustee Hebda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you.
Okay, is there a motion to adjourn committee to hold?
Before we do that, because I missed on the okay. Blackhawks won the Stanley Cup last night.
No.
Really?
And we have in the past, when the White Sox won, I know we went whole hog and provided a letter to.
Sure. We did it the last two times for the Hawks, too.
I couldn't remember that as well as I remember the Sox.
Bring the Stanley
Cup. Anyway, I'd like to make sure that we provide a
letter. Is there any way to get the cup to come to town?
And that would be the yes. It would fit perfectly on
well,
the presentation
that's
altar.
That's up to
I know.
John Miller and Eric Schneider. If it's coming to town, it would be at Glacier. And I don't want to imply that it's going to be at Glacier anytime. But if that's about the only place it would come in town.
Probably. Well, it might go to a local.
If it's good. But it didn't come. I don't think it's ever been there.
No. Well, we could request it.
We might.
Draft. So what this is to draft a letter to Rocky Works, right?
Yes. Rockwell. Right. We'll be formal.
Okay.
Yeah.
For my signature.
Lynn was alerted today.
Yes.
Yeah, okay, great. All right. Is that it?
That's it for me.
Okay. Larry said we're done.
Larry said good. Larry said that's it.
All right. Okay, there's a motion.
And a second.
And we're going to go in for personnel and litigation.
Right.
Correct.
Okay, roll call.
Trustee Williams?
Aye.
Trustee Hebda?
Aye.
Trustee Schultz?
Aye.
Trustee Marquardt?
Aye.
Trustee Cook?
Aye.
Trustee Schwartz?
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you and good night.